And for some reaction from the Australian Islamic community, we're joined now by the founder of Australia's Islamic Friendship Association, Kezar Trad. He joins us on the telephone. Kezar, good morning to you. What is the general reaction from the Muslim community in Australia to the announcement of Osama bin Laden's death?
Most people in the Muslim community have been under the impression that he died a long time ago. Now, this news of his death brings closure to the situation, and most people have been indifferent to him, although have been quite concerned and upset that his reputation was impacting on Muslims and creating negative feelings. So most people would be relieved that of this news, that this episode of conflict is over now. We've struggled for 10 years trying to overcome the image that has been created by bin Laden, and now we can say that this is behind us and look forward to a future of conciliation and greater understanding and cooperation. The human family really needs greater understanding and cooperation for a better future.
Well, of course, that's a hope, and we'll come back to that in just a moment. But we've heard now from political leaders, both here and overseas, that there are actually increasing concerns that the radical Islamic groups may step up their efforts against the West. In fact, the Prime Minister was just asked by Matt Moran then what if there was an increased likelihood of some sort of revenge here in Australia. Really, she sort of sidestepped that. Are there radical elements of Islam still in Australia that could step up their actions?
I think that our security agencies in Australia, whether it's the Federal Police or ASIO, I think they're very, very vigilant. They have proved themselves to be very, very capable over the years, and I don't think that there's any threat. I think we're under a very good watch at the moment, and we should really have the confidence in our security services that they've already proved themselves year after year. And we should not be raising the alarm over this. Now, this doesn't mean that we should not be careful. Of course, we should be careful. And that part of the Prime Minister's message I certainly endorse. We should always take care and take caution. But we should not blow this out of perspective. For many people, Osama bin Laden was effectively dead. There's been another spokesman for that group for many years. And now it just makes it official that he's dead. And most people, even those who might have sympathised with him, they would have looked at his death as bringing closure to a situation where nobody wants to be on the run for all their lives. And we're all going to die, you know, sooner or later. Now, for those who sympathise with him, okay, he died in battle. So they would get some comfort from that. Those who were indifferent, like the rest of us, the vast majority of Muslims the world over, were actually either antagonistic or indifferent to him. And for them, this news brings hope of closure. It brings a sense of relief, and it brings a number of opportunities for engagement and to allow us to actually show that our faith is a faith of salvation for humanity and not a faith of condemnation.
Kezar, you mentioned there that the possibility and the chance for reconciliation. Over the years, there has been a growing antagonism in this country between the Muslim community and the rest of the community. How do we go about repairing that relationship now that we have this marvellous opportunity?
Well, I think it has to start with words of goodwill. And what President Obama said yesterday, that his country will never be at war with Islam, I think that was the first signal, and all credit goes to him for making such a courageous statement at a time where you've got some opposition figures or future opposition figures such as Donald Trump who are ramping up the rhetoric. What we need to do is put the negative rhetoric into perspective, and responsible leaders like Obama and our Prime Minister and perhaps European leaders to come out and make conciliatory comments and show that they are willing to embrace their Muslim constituents, and the Muslim constituents have already extended their arms. The comments I've been following up from Muslims all over the world, imams, community leaders, organisation leaders, have been comments of relief, comments of conciliation, comments where they are outstretching their arms to say to the rest of the world that we've always wanted to be friends. Now the obstacle to this friendship is behind us. Let us move forward.
Let's hope that is exactly what happens. Kezar Trad from the Islamic Friendship Association, we thank you very much for speaking with us live this morning.
Thank you.